Today you will learn how to build a Hello Web application written in Eiffel. For this video, you'll need to have Eiffel Studio 14.11 or greater installed. This project is using the Eiffel Web Framework and in particular the Web Server Foundation library, which is used on top of a small layer called a connector. That layer is used to interact with the web server using any of the following technologies: CGI, FastCGI, or Nino, the standalone HTTP server written in Eiffel. We will be using Nino as it works locally without having to configure any settings. Also, using Nino lets you debug your web application directly in the Eiffel Studio debugger. So let's create a new project. Name it Hello Web. And we will add two libraries, WSF and the default Nino library. For that, we go into Project Settings and we look up the WSF library and add it. Then we need to add the Nino library. Because it does not show up in the list of libraries, we're going to select the WSF library and simply modify the path to the right location of the Nino library, which is under WSF/default/ninosafe.ecf. Once this is compiled, we can open the root class. Let's add an inheritance clause to WSF default service, which turns this application into a web service. And let's call make and launch, which is defined in the new parent we just added. When you compile your changes, you will get an error about a non-implemented deferred feature execute. This routine is called each time there is an incoming request, and it will actually provide a response to any incoming HTTP request. Let's copy the signature of this routine into our root class. We will use the response argument to send a simple response. We will create a simple WSF page response containing just the Hello Web string. By default, Nino listen on the HTTP port 80. Most likely this port is already taken, so you need to change this to a non-used one if you want to execute your application. Let's redefine initialize in order to specify another port. We use set service option with parameter port, and let's use 9090. We will also enable the verbose output in the console to see some more details about the execution. After compiling our project, we will set a breakpoint in execute to see when we receive a request in the web server. Now if we go to localhost 9090, we see that it stops at the breakpoints and that we have access to the request and the response. By continuing the execution, we see the output in the web browser, Hello Web. This was a simple introduction to EWF. Check out our other videos where you will learn how to use URL dispatching and other more advanced topics of EWF. Thank you for watching.